Let me start with our goal. Given the two-dimensional vector field, we want to deduce the face portrait. That means the picture of all qualitatively different trajectories and extract some qualitative info, such as the existence and stability of fixed points, as well as any periodic orbits or closed orbits. So that's our general goal when we analyze a 2D autonomous ODE. And there's a few tools that we can use to do that. Some of them are topological that we talked about last time. Often we'll start with fixed points. So if we can find fixed points, we can analyze what the dynamics looks like near fixed points. But let me give another example. I think I gave one last time of the bead in the rotating hoop. Right now I'll do the pendulum, which is another common example. The pendulum, we've got a mass suspended by a rigid rod. It can swing back and forth freely. So the main variable there is theta. And don't necessarily worry how we get this, but we get this second order ordinary differential equation. If this thing has a length L, then we have this second order ODE, and then we turn it into two first order ODEs. We first define V is equal to theta dot, but then that gives us our first ODE. Theta dot equals V, and then we write theta double dot as V dot. It's negative G over L sine theta. For this, we could sketch the phase portrait. For small angles, what do we have? It's be theta, and this is V. Well, what we'll have, if you were to evaluate what the vector field looks like, say along the V axis, see that it's the vector field goes to zero at 0, 0. And then along the V axis, things are pointing, at least for positive V, pointing to the right exactly, and below pointing to the left with increasing magnitude as we go further down. And also on the theta axis, things are pointing down, positive theta axis, and getting larger. And if on the negative theta axis, pointing up, getting larger. The phase portrait, at least for just close to the origin, is going to look like a bunch of closed curves. So here is a closed curve. We could draw arrows on it showing the direction of the motion. So this is, in this case, it's actually all closed curves, especially next to the origin. If you look at a bigger picture, you get a bigger idea, but you often, especially for something that's a mechanical system like this, you can visualize what each point in phase space corresponds to. So at this point up here, on say the larger blue cycle, I could do a little sketch. This is the pendulum. It's facing down because theta equals to zero, but V is positive. So this thing is moving to the right. And then at this point, I do another little snapshot. Pendulum has reached its maximum extent. So the velocity has stopped and it's about to go back. Pick a point here, some intermediate angle, and V is negative and V is equal to theta dot. So the theta is decreasing. So this is going, if I do a little green arrow, this is going to the left here. Again, theta is pointing down, but it's moving completely to the left. This would be the pendulum to the left at its greatest extent, and it's about to go back. So we have this sort of snapshot picture of what's going on. If we were to plot the whole thing, theta is on the circle. Sometimes I'll write this. That's the mathematical symbol for the circle. And you're like, what's S1? It implies there's an S2. Oh no, what's that? That would be the sphere. If you want, we're just treating theta as a portion of the real line. So it's, you know, negative pi to pi. So if I were to do that full region and plot it out, it shows at least two features, the downward position. And then if at plus or minus pi, right, theta is measured from the bottom. So theta at plus or minus pi means the inverted pendulum position, which if I try to balance this, right, it's unstable. You can do it for a little bit, but then it falls over. So it's the unstable point. This picture here would qualify as a good phase portrait because it shows all of the qualitative behavior and all of the fixed points, and it reveals their stability. We've got this fixed point in the middle, which is stable. Why do I say it's stable? Because everything around it is not leaving. It's just sort of circulating around. So we also might plot in this region. All of the trajectories in this yellow region here are all doing basically the same thing. They're closed orbits, and they're all just oscillating back and forth. We also have an unstable point, the upright pendulum position. And if we were to follow the convention of Strogatz, we'd make those an open circle. Plus, these two are the same position, right? This is it. Theta is negative pi, and here's theta equals pi. And we know that those are the same thing. So we might say identify. All right, and outside of this purple thing that I'll get to later, think of the trajectories that are up here. I'll color this blue. All these blue things, any trajectory in the blue region is going past the upright position, and it's just circulating around in one direction in a counterclockwise way. And then I've got another color here. What about down here? These would be things circulating in a clockwise way. And this is even missing some arrows. You always want to have arrows so you know which way things are going. So then I'd say, this is a good face portrait. And we could even start labeling regions. We give them names, circulating counterclockwise. Down here would be circulating clockwise. And maybe we'd label this inside region oscillating. So we're separating the idea of oscillating back and forth from circulating around. Like you hit the pendulum hard enough, it'll go all the way around. Okay, so this would be the good phase portrait. We'd say this is the phase portrait for the pendulum. We haven't shown like every possible trajectory, right? There's infinite trajectories. Take any line along there and pick initial conditions, it'll be a different trajectory. We've shown a sampling of them that reveals all of the important stuff. So this is the phase portrait of the pendulum. So this is a video showing the pendulum on one of those trajectories that's oscillating. This is a very large amplitude. So that you could, I imagine phase space, at least when you have the vectors, it's kind of like you have a imaginary fluid and any initial condition dropped in there and then you release it, it's like a particle moving in the fluid. In this case, everything is in the green region here, oscillating region, everything's a closed orbit. And then this just visualizes on the left what the pendulum looks like at that position. Okay, in general, you won't have a bunch of closed orbits. That's something that's very special. There's some other weird things. That upright position of the pendulum, there seems to be directions. Look at the left side thing. This direction, if I start at the upright position, but then I slightly perturb in the direction of that orange arrow, then I'm on a trajectory which will actually come back asymptotically back to the upright position. So it's like giving this thing a little bit of a nudge, and then it goes away and it comes right back asymptotically. And if I were to do that in the other direction, then I get something that's asymptotically clockwise. So it goes, and it comes right back. Those are special trajectories. It's a trajectory that asymptotic, it's doubly asymptotic. It's asymptotic in backward time and forward time to the same fixed point. It's called a homoclinic orbit. And we'll talk about those later. Right now, you could just see that, it seems to form a boundary between qualitatively different types of behavior, the circulating counterclockwise, the oscillating, and the circulating clockwise. So they are sometimes called this strange name here, this boundary, separatrix, because it separates qualitatively different types of behavior. So eventually those will become important, but you'll notice they grow out of the fixed points. So it seems like the fixed points are a good thing to focus on first if we're to do some study of phase portraits. That's what we'll look at now. We'll analyze behavior near fixed points.